The game of football can be very exciting as well as extremely frustrating. No matter how much you train or how many precautions you take, there's always one thing that can stop every athlete: injuries. Injuries are inescapable and are responsible for many pro athletes' careers. Names like Derrick Rose, Bo Jackson, and Andrew Luck are some familiar names that had their careers cut short because of injury. But one name that you might not be familiar with is Jordan White. The Western Michigan receiver, who has the fourth most receiving yards in a single season, was never able to have a productive NFL career because of injury. In this video, we're going to find out exactly what injuries plagued Jordan White, and also find out his other weaknesses that held him back from having a solid career in the pros. Guys, before we get into the video, I would really appreciate it if y'all liked this video and subscribed if you enjoy the content that I put out. It would mean a lot, and it only takes a second to do. Now let's get into the video. Jordan White attended North Ridgeville High School in North Ridgeville, Ohio. At North Ridgeville, Jordan ended his high school career with 51 receptions for 646 yards and 21 carries for 352 yards, and a total of 15 touchdowns. Not very productive career numbers, but it was enough to win him first team All-Lorain County in his senior and junior year, as well as honorable mention All-State team. According to ESPN, Jordan was not even ranked coming out of high school, which isn't a huge surprise considering his production. However, he did have one offer to Western Michigan and decided to take it. Jordan decided to redshirt his first year at Western Michigan due to injury. The injury he sustained was a torn anterior cruciate ligament in his right knee, and as you'll find out, this would not be his last injury. This injury actually had a much bigger impact than most might expect, because it was said by Western Michigan coach that Jordan was the best guy they had out there before his injury, and he would have been a starter had he not gotten injured. And to be a starter as a true freshman, even at a smaller school, is really impressive. But he appeared in 9 games his redshirt freshman season and tallied up 217 yards on 19 receptions and just 1 touchdown. Not too bad for a freshman, but not exactly overly productive either. But as you'll see in his stats, Jordan's role steadily got bigger, and with that came more production every year. Then came his redshirt sophomore season, and Jordan was ready to make his biggest impact yet. But as fate would have it, Jordan would end up getting injured again, and this time it was a cartilage tear in his left knee. For the injury, he got an original diagnosis of 4 to 6 weeks to recover, but it eventually turned into another lost season. So far, Jordan was 1 for 3 on healthy seasons in college. So what should have been Jordan's fourth healthy season, but is actually his second, has arrived. In the 2009 season, Jordan racked up 681 yards on 53 receptions and 4 touchdowns, which is noticeably better than his 2007 redshirt freshman season. But over the next 2 seasons, Jordan would put up unbelievable numbers and finally showed what he was able to do when he was healthy. Over the next 2 seasons, Jordan put up a combined 3,289 receiving yards on 234 receptions and 27 touchdowns. In his junior season, he had 1,378 receiving yards on 94 receptions and 10 touchdowns. At the end of that season, Jordan was a Biletnikoff semifinalist, the school leader for receiving yards in a season, and 100-yard receiving games with 7, and was first team All-MAC. But the season that people would remember him for was his senior year, in which he had 1,911 yards on 140 receptions and 17 touchdowns. Those 1,911 receiving yards are still the fourth most of all time. At the end of the season, Jordan had set a new school single game record for receiving yards of 265. He was the MAC leader in career receiving yards with 4,187, the MAC leader in receiving yards in one season with 1,911, breaking his record from the previous year, and he was a Biletnikoff Award semifinalist. So after a rough start to a promising career, Jordan was able to put together an excellent 2-year campaign to end his collegiate career. So going into the 2012 NFL draft, Jordan was predicted to go around the 5th round to not being drafted at all. Now, if you just look at his stats and nothing else, you can make the argument that Jordan could have gone around the 1st to 3rd round. But unfortunately for Jordan, stats are not the only thing that makes a good NFL player. Some red flags that scouts are pointing out were, first and most obvious, his injury history. If you tear both ACLs in college, no matter how good you are, that's going to take a hit on your draft stock. So injuries were a factor, but along with that, his size. Now, he wasn't extremely undersized, standing at 6 foot, because there's been plenty of receivers in the NFL that are elite that are under 6 foot. But what set me off when I read it was that Jordan clocked a 4.72 40, which is extremely slow. So considering all of those factors, Jordan ended up being drafted with the 244th overall pick in the 7th round to the New York Jets. So now, after being injured in college twice and tearing both ACLs and then bouncing back in the tail end of his college career, Jordan was now officially an NFL player. But then he went and got injured again. About a month after the draft, during the Jets' first session of organized activities, Jordan broke the 5th metatarsal in his foot. So after having his foot operated on, he was expected to miss at least the next month. So, just to recap, Jordan was very injury prone in college. He's a bit undersized, and he's very slow. And now, he's not even getting a chance to prove his ability because he sustained another injury within the first month of becoming an NFL player. So throughout the next couple of months, Jordan would be moved around a lot as he was waived in September, then re-signed to the practice squad in October, and then ended up on the active roster in November. However, this would not go anywhere, as in his one and only season in the NFL, Jordan caught only one pass for 13 yards. Jordan ended up being cut in August of 2013, just before the regular season started during final roster cuts. And after he was cut, I don't think he was re-signed or decided to go to the CFL or even try to play football again, because I couldn't find anything on that, but you know, he might have. Jordan Wyatt was an incredibly productive receiver. He proved for two straight seasons that when he's healthy, he's an elite talent that few DBs could guard well. But unfortunately, one thing that got in the way of him becoming a great NFL player was injuries. It really is a tragedy that Jordan went through those two ACL tears in college, but still managed to get drafted from a smaller school. But even after he was drafted, he could not escape the injuries and eventually was cut because of it. As we all know, injuries are unavoidable no matter how healthy you are or how many precautions you take. And the list could go on and on of players whose careers were cut short by injury and whose players' careers were made possible because of someone else's injury. Because who knows, without injuries, we could be looking at a very different NFL.